Welcome to a video on the applications of inequalities. The goal of this video is to solve application problems. Let's start by taking a look at key words and the translation of those into inequalities. Raul is at least 8 years old. The key words there, at least, would translate into x is greater than or equal to 8. At most, 3 students failed the course. That would translate into x less than or equal to 3. Your speed cannot exceed 55 miles per hour. That would be x is less than or equal to 55. Your grade must exceed 69 points. X must be greater than 69. Luke is less than 160 pounds. X is less than 160. LA is more than 300 miles away. X is greater than 300. A movie is between 105 and 140 minutes. Would be a compound inequality. 105 less than X less than 140. You can also read this X is greater than 105 and X is less than 140. A car weighs no more than 1,560 pounds. X is less than or equal to 1,560. And lastly, Carmela scored no less than 94 points, meaning X is greater than or equal to 94. Okay, let's start by translating a sentence into an inequality. The price of Sheila's car exceeded $18,500. So if we let P equal the price, we know it could be more than $18,500. But the real question is, can it also equal $18,500? If we read this again, it states the price exceeded $18,500. So that means it could not equal that. It had to be more than that. So we're done here. Number two, Glendale Community College is no more than 15 miles away. So the distance D is no more than 15 miles away. That means it could be less than or equal to 15 miles. And lastly, the monthly rental cannot exceed $625. So it can't be more than this, so of course it could be less. But again, the question becomes, can it equal 625? And it can, because $625 does not exceed $625. Okay, let's take a look at a couple problems now. Pete's Plumbing charges $65 plus $60 per hour for plumbing repair. Jonas remembers being billed less than $350. How many hours was Jonas's copier worked on? So the total cost was less than $350, but the cost is made up of the $65 charge plus the $60 per hour charge. So the $65 is our fixed cost, meaning that does not change based upon how many hours it took, but the $60 per hour does change. So if we let X equal the number of hours, we can replace the cost with $65 plus $60 per hour, so 60 times X, which must be less than $350. If we solve this inequality for X, we'll know how many hours the copier was worked on. So we'll subtract 65 on both sides. This will give us 285 divided by 60. X is less than 4.75 hours. Now, if this company bills to the nearest hour, X would have to be less than 4 hours. But if they did bill for fractions of hours, it could be any value less than 4.75 hours. We don't know the exact length of the job, but this gives us an idea of what's possible for how long the job took. Let's go ahead and take a look at another. Samantha has test grades 86, 88, and 78 on her first three math tests. If she wants an average of at least 80 after the fourth test, what possible scores can she earn on the fourth test? Well, remember, to find the average of the four tests, we would add them up and divide by 4. So if we let x equal the score of the fourth test, the average of the four tests would be obtained by taking x and adding it to the three other test scores and dividing this by 4, and she wants her average to be at least 80, which means it has to be greater than or equal to 80. So now if we solve this for x, the first thing we do is multiply both sides by 4. That would give us x plus this sum, which is equal to 252 greater than or equal to 320. Subtract 252. And we have x has to be greater than or equal to 68. So if that fourth test score is greater than or equal to 68, she will have an average of at least 80, which will give her at least a B. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.